بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. So far we've covered الدرس الثالث. We've read the passage and we have explained the new concepts that are contained in this passage. Now we need to test our understanding by going through the homework which we set last lesson. The first exercise, أجب عن الأسئلة الآتية. Answer the following questions. And these questions are related to the passage. So this is to test your comprehension. The first question, كم طالبا في فصل أحمد? كم طالبا في فصل أحمد? How many students were in Ahmed's class? And I went through this. I wrote down the answers, and it's quite tricky. It's quite tricky. So we need to focus. How many students in Ahmed's class? Ahmed says, الطلاب في فصل أكثر فيه تسعة عشر طالبا. So you might look at the first number and think, okay, في فصلنا أربعة عشر طالبا, there's 14 students. If you was to write 14 students, that's wrong, because it's Ali that's speaking. You have to focus. Ahmed is the one that was speaking, or he's the one that's being asked about how many students in Ahmed's class. So we'd say فيه تسعة عشر طالبا. So I've written this down here. فيه تسعة عشر طالبا. There's 19 students in Ahmed's class. So this is one way of answering, or you could say في فصل أحمد تسعة عشر طالبا. In Ahmed's class there are 19 students. Or you can say في فصله, in his class there are 19 students. There's a variety of answers. The main thing is making sure that you've said تسعة عشر طالبا. So you can say فيه تسعة عشر طالبا, or في فصل أحمد تسعة عشر طالبا, or في فصله تسعة عشر طالبا. The next question, كم طالبا في فصل علي? كم طالبا في فصل علي? How many students in Ali's class? This is where we go to this sentence now. في فصلنا أربعة عشر طالبا. فيه أربعة عشر طالبا. فيه أربعة عشر طالبا. In it there are 14 students. Or you could say في فصله أربعة عشر طالبا. Or في فصل علي أربعة عشر طالبا. Any of those answers will be correct. The next question, question 3. من أطول طالب في فصل أحمد? من أطول طالب في فصل أحمد? Who is the tallest student in Ahmed's class? In Ahmed's class, yeah? You have to be careful. So Ahmed says, هو طويل جدا, ليس كذلك. Ali, بلى, هو طالب. هو طويل جدا, ولكن حامد أطول من. So it's Ali speaking here. We don't want Ali. We want Ahmed. أطول طالب في فصلنا إبراهيم. So in Ahmed's class, the tallest student is Ibrahim. طيب, so we write, أطول طالب في فصل أحمد إبراهيم. And remember, Ahmed is ممنوع من الصرف. So, مضاف مضاف إليه, فصل أحمد, فصل أحمد إبراهيم. أطول طالب إبراهيم. So this is مبتدأ and this is the خبر. Everything else is additional. So مبتدأ مضاف مضاف إليه في فصل جار مجور مضاف مضاف إليه إبراهيم خبر. So this is the main components of the sentence. أطول طالب إبراهيم. طيب, that's three. ومن أطول طالب في فصل علي? And who is the tallest student in Ali's class? In Ali's class. طيب, علي بلى هو طالب, هو طويل جدا, ولكن حامد أطول منه. إنه أطول طالب في فصلنا. علي said regarding حامد, إنه أطول طالب في فصلنا. So حامد is the tallest. أطول طالب في فصله حامد. Who is the tallest student in Ali's class? أطول طالب في فصله حامد. The tallest student is in his class is حامد. Or you could say أطول طالب في فصل علي حامد. Once again, مبتدأ, and this is the خبر. So that's the first exercise. The next exercise, it says we need to place a tick or a cross. If the sentence is right, tick. If the sentence is wrong, we need to place a cross. الطالب الجديد الذي جاء أمس اسمه أسامة. The new student who came yesterday, his name is أسامة. Is that the case? الطالب الجديد. يا علي, ما اسم الطالب الجديد الذي جاء أمس? What's the name of the new student who came yesterday? Ali said, اسمه أسامة. اسمه أسامة. So this sentence is correct. الطالب الجديد الذي جاء أمس اسمه أسامة. So we'd put a tick. So you write this out in your notebook and then you place a tick. The next one, Hamidun fi fasli Ahmed. Hamid fi fasli Ahmed. Hamid, remember, he was the tallest student in one of their classes. Is he in Ahmed's class or Ali's class? When Ali was speaking, he said, Hamidun atwalu minhu, innahu atwalu talibi fi faslina. So Hamid is in Ali's class. Hamid is in Ali's class. Here they've said, Hamid fi fasli Ahmed. So this is wrong. Bal Hamid fi fasli Ali. He's in Ali's class, not Ahmed's class. So this is wrong. Al-mahja'u al-thaminu ghurafahu awsa'. The eighth dormitory, its rooms are more spacious. Let's see. Al-mahja'u al-khamis ahsan. So when he was talking about al-mahja'u al-khamis, that's where he said ghurafahu. Where is it? Fa'inna ghurafahu awsa'. So he was talking about al-mahja'u al-khamis, not al-mahja'u al-thamin. So this is wrong. Al-mahja'u al-thamin ghurafahu awsa'. This is wrong. Bal al-mahja'u al-khamis ghurafahu awsa'. The final one. المهجع الثامن أبعد من المهجع الخامس. The eighth dormitory is further away than the fifth. Is that the case? المهجع أنا في المهجع الثامن وهو أبعد من مهجعكم. I am in the eighth dormitory and it is further away than your dormitory, which is the fifth dormitory. So, yes, this is right. المهجع الثامن أبعد من المهجع الخامس. صحيح. So we place a tick. So that's the second exercise. The third exercise is a reading exercise. So let's read. It says here, اقرأ الأمثلة الآتية لاسم التفضيل. Read the following examples of اسم التفضيل. هاشم طويل. هاشم is tall. وحامد أطول منه. And Hamid is taller than him. So this is the comparative degree. We mentioned the last lesson when explaining the rules for comparative degree that we need four things. We need the مفضل, which is Hamid here. The one who's exceeding the other in that particular quality. And it's not always going to be a good thing. It doesn't always mean that this person is better than this or richer or taller and so on. It could possibly be a bad quality that they're talking about. Maybe who's more dumb? Man أغبى. Who's أسوأ خلقاً? Bad mannered and so on. So it doesn't mean that this one is always better than this one. It's just this person is more than this one in the degree of the quality that you're talking about, the characteristic you're talking about. That characteristic could either be good or bad. So this is the mufaddal. And then we have to have the ismu tafdil. Then we have to have min. And then we have to have the mufaddal alayhi. And the mufaddal alayhi can come as a normal noun or it can come as a dhamir, in which case it has to attach onto min. This is what I mentioned last lesson. So these are examples here. Hamidun atwalu minhu. So Hashim is tall, but Hamid is taller than him. Aminatu saghiratun. Wa Zainabu asgharu minha. So Amina is small, but Zainab is smaller than her. And one thing we need to also bear in mind is that there was an af'al. It's mufrad, mudhakkar. It's singular and it's masculine. There is a feminine version of af'al, and that is fu'la, fu'la. So if we were to say Ahsan is masculine, Husna is feminine. But here we don't change it. We don't change it. We don't make it feminine. We don't say Zainabu Sughra. We don't say Sughra. We say Asghar. This is one of the rules. That if you're using the Ismu Tafdil in the comparative setup, the comparative degree format, then it's going to stay in the same form. Mufrad Mudhakkar. It doesn't change. Look how we are using the same pattern, ismu tafdil, af'alu, af'alu, whether we're referring to male or whether we're referring to female. In the comparative degree, the ismu tafdil remains unchanged. Hamidun atwalu minhu, Zainab asgharu minha. It remains the same. Tayyib, you use the mufrad mudhakkar form, which is af'al. That's the standard pattern, that's the standard wazn. Tayyib. Further examples. هذا الكتاب أسهل من ذاك. هذا الكتاب أسهل من ذاك. This book is easier than that one. هذه السيارة أجمل من تلك. هذه السيارة أجمل من تلك. This car is more beautiful than that one. حمزة أكبر مني سنا. حمزة أكبر مني سنا. Hamza is older than me in age. If we have a ismu tafdil, and then after the ismu tafdil there is a noun which is mufrad, mudhakkar, mansub, then the i'rab of that noun is tamiz. It is tamiz. طيب. Anytime you find the ism tafdil followed somewhere after the sentence by a mufrad, mudhakkar, mansub noun, then the i'rab of that noun is going to be tamiz. And this comes to clarify what the ism tafdil is referring to. Sometimes the ism tafdil can be ambiguous. It needs clarifying. That's why we bring the tamiz. He is bigger than me in what way? Is he bigger than me in size? Hajman. Is he bigger than me in age? So this is why the ambiguity is removed by mentioning the tamiz. For example, I could say, Ana aktharu minka. I am more than you. More than you in what way? It's ambiguous. So we bring a tamiz, a noun which is mufrad, mudhakkar, mansub, to remove the ambiguity. So we say, Ana aktharu minka malan. I am more than you in wealth. Ana aktharu minka waladan. I am more than you in children. Ana aktharu minka ilman. And so on. طيب. So this, the i'rab of this is tamiz, and it comes to remove ambiguity in the ism al-tafdil. هؤلاء الطلاب أحسن من أولئك. هؤلاء الطلاب أحسن من أولئك. These students are better than those. بيتي أبعد عن المدرسة من بيتك. من بيتك. بيتي أبعد عن المدرسة من بيتك. My house is further away from the school than your house. هو أصغر منا سنا. هو أصغر منا سنا. He is younger than us in age. Once again, sinnan, this is tamiz. It's come to remove the ambiguity in asghar, what you're referring to. So he's younger, that's what it means now. It's smaller in terms of age. خطي أحسن من خطك. خطي أحسن من خطك. My handwriting is better than your handwriting. هذا الشارع أنظف من ذلك. هذا الشارع أنظف من ذلك. This street is cleaner than that. اللبن أحسن من الشاي. اللبن أحسن من الشاي. Milk is better than tea. هذه الساعة أرخص من تلك. هذه الساعة أرخص من تلك. This watch is cheaper than that one. These are examples of ism al-tafdil being used in different sentences. And you'll notice, as we mentioned, that in the comparative degree, the ism al-tafdil is coming as khabar. So this is mubtada, khabar is the ism al-tafdil. Mubtada, khabar. Mubtada, khabar. Mubtada, khabar. You find that with all of them, the khabar is the ism al-tafdil. And this is the case most of the time, that the ism al-tafdil, in these cases, they come as khabar. The next exercise, we need to create كون جملا من الكلمات الآتية مستعملا اسم التفضيل. Create sentences from the following words using اسم التفضيل. So the sifa, the adjective, which is the middle one, has to be changed into the اسم التفضيل form. And then we need to create the comparative degree, applying the rules that we learned. So المفضل comes first, then the اسم التفضيل, then من, then the مفضل عليه. Those four things. من hasn't been mentioned. This is something that you're supposed to have already picked up, that you have to have min after ism al-tafdil. طيب, I've written this down. So we have Hashim طويل عثمان. Hashim طويل عثمان will be Hashim أطول من عثمان. Hashim أطول من عثمان. Hashim is taller than عثمان. القاهرة كبير الرياض. القاهرة كبير الرياض. القاهرة أكبر من الرياض. القاهرة أكبر من الرياض. Cairo is bigger than Riyadh. The next one. هذا الفندق نظيف ذاك. هذا الفندق نظيف ذاك. هذا الفندق أنظف من ذاك. هذا الفندق أنظف من ذاك. This hotel is cleaner than that one. This hotel is cleaner than that one. اللغة العربية سهل. اللغة الفرنسية. اللغة العربية سهل، اللغة الفرنسية. اللغة العربية أسهل من اللغة الفرنسية. اللغة العربية أسهل من اللغة الفرنسية. The Arabic language is easier than the French language. And on the next page, it continues. We have أنا كبير هو. أنا كبير هو. أنا أكبر من هو. أنا أكبر من هو. I am older than him. I'm bigger than him. So هو is a ضمير منفصل, detached pronoun. This is not going to attach to the harf jar. It does not come after the harf jar. The munfasil dhamir, you never find them after harf jar. It has to transform into the muttasil form before it comes after the harf jar. So you never have the muttasil, the munfasil versions, the detached versions coming after harf jar. It has to be its corresponding muttasil version. Ana akbaru minhu. I am older than him. I am bigger than him. Huwa saghirun anta. هو صغير أنت. هو أصغر منك. هو أصغر منك. He is smaller than you. Is it size? Is it age? He hasn't mentioned, so it's still ambiguous. If you want to remove the ambiguity, you say هو أصغر منك سنا. He is smaller than you in age, not size. طيب, the next one. الرجال كثير النساء. الرجال كثير النساء. الرجال أكثر من النساء. الرجال أكثر من النساء. Men are more than women. Men are more than women. I don't think this statement is true. I think it's actually the opposite. النساء أكثر من الرجال. النساء أكثر من الرجال. Women are more than men. Women are more than men. والله أعلم. Maybe he's referring to the university, that the number of pupils, male pupils, are more than the number of female pupils, Allah alam. But generally speaking, I think there's more women in the world than men. So the next one, anta hasanun ana. Anta hasanun ana. Anta ahsanu minni. Anta ahsanu minni. The muttasil version for ana in this case is ya al mutakallim. Ya al mutakallim. Ya with a sukun. And this ya requires a kasra before it. It requires a kasra before it. So when we attach this ya onto min, the noon is supposed to take a kasra. But in this particular case, it doesn't take a kasra. We add an additional noon. There's an additional noon that carries the kasra. And this additional noon which carries the kasra is written here. So we have noon. This noon is additional. It carries the kasra for the ya. And then when we attach it, it becomes min, min, and then ni, noon, noon, two noons. So the same letter, the first of which has a sukun and the second has a haraka, this is a shadda. This equates to a shadda, which is why it's written like this. Minni, minni, but it's read like this. In writing, it's written like this. So this is where we got minni from. We add an additional noon to carry the kasra for the ya, because that is the muttasil version of ana. The next one, al-mawzu rakhisun al-inab. Al-mawzu rakhisun al-inab. Al-mawzu arkhasu min al-inab. Al-mawzu arkhasu min al-inab. Banana is cheaper than grapes. The final one, ash-shamsu ba'idun al-qamar. Ash-shamsu ba'idun al-qamar. Ash-shamsu ab'adu min al-qamar. الشمس أبعد من القمر. The sun is further away than the moon. The next exercise, اقرأ الأمثلة. Read the examples. ثم حول الجمل الآتية على غرار مستمع اسم التفضيل. So we need to read the examples and then change the sentences similar to it using اسم التفضيل. So محمد طالب حسن. محمد is a good student. محمد أحسن طالب في الفصل. محمد is the best student in the class. هذا بيت جميل. This is a beautiful house. هذا أجمل بيت في الشارع. This is the most beautiful house on the street. آمنة طالبة صغيرة. آمنة is a small student. آمنة أصغر طالبة في المدرسة. آمنة is the smallest student in the school. So what are we noticing here? We're noticing that we're using the superlative degree. We're making the adjective we're transferring the adjective into the ism al-tafdil, and then we're making it mudaf, and then we have mudaf ilayhi, which is the thing that we are comparing, the best student, the best house, and so on. That becomes the mudaf ilayhi. And likewise, in this case, where it's mudaf ilayhi, the ism al-tafdil assumes the same case. It doesn't change whether you're talking about male, female, plural, singular, dual. The ism al-tafdil remains in the same case, af'al throughout. So in this case, where the ism al-tafdil is mudaf to a nakira noun, it's an indefinite noun, yeah? So this is the rule. The ism al-tafdil has various rules. طيب, but the author has brought two rules in this lesson. The first one is the comparative degree. In the comparative degree, it's always going to be af'al, it doesn't change. And here in the superlative degree, if it's mudaf to nakira, likewise, it's always going to be in the same case. If it's mudaf to nakira, it's possible that we can make it mudaf to a ma'rifa noun. If it's mudaf to a ma'rifa noun, the rules are different. We're not going to speak about that right now. So just bear that in mind, yeah? So in the superlative degree, if it's mudaf to a nakira noun, the ism al-tafdil remains in the same case, whether you're talking about masculine, feminine, you're talking about plural, singular, dual, it remains the same. طيب, so I've done this in my notebook. هذه غرفة صغيرة. هذه غرفة صغيرة. This is a small room. هذه أصغر غرفة في بيتنا. هذه أصغر غرفة في بيتنا. This is the smallest room in our house. So صغيرةٌ becomes أصغرُ. And likewise صغيرٌ becomes أصغرُ. Whether it's صغيرةٌ with the تمربوطة, without the تمربوطة, if you put it on اسم التفضيل, the تمربوطة is taken off. أصغرُ. And then غرفة is what we're talking about, so it becomes مضاف إليه. أصغرُ غرفةٍ في بيتنا. So this is the smallest room in our house. بلالٌ جارٌ حسنٌ. بلالٌ جارٌ حسنٌ. بلال is a good neighbor. And when you read jar, you should say it with the light, ra. Jarun. Jarun means neighbor. But if you were to say jarun with a shadda, that is a short way of saying jarun wa majrur. We've been saying that for a long time, right? The harf jar and the ism majrur gives you jar wa majrur. Jar wa majrur, the jar has a shadda. It's written the same way, but it has a shadda on the ra. But without the shadda, jarun is neighbor. Jarun is something that pulls down. The harf jar is a jar. It makes the noun after it end with a kasra. It pulls the dhamma down to a kasra, as we've been mentioning throughout the lessons. So just bear that in mind. Bilalun jarun hasanun. Bilal is a good neighbor. Bilalun ahsanu jarin fi hayyina. Bilalun ahsanu jarin fi hayyina. Bilal is the best neighbor in our district, in our neighborhood. Yasirun rajulun faqirun. Yasirun rajulun faqirun. Yasir is a poor man. Yasirun afqaru rajulin fi qaryatina. Naam, qaryatina. Need to make the dots a bit more clear. Yasirun afqaru rajulin fi qaryatina. Yasirun afqaru rajulin fi qaryatina. Yasir is the poorest man in our village. Hadhihi sa'atun rakhisatun. هذه ساعة رخيصة. This is a cheap watch. هذه أرخص ساعة في السوق. هذه أرخص ساعة في السوق. This is the cheapest watch in the market. هذا درس سهل. هذا درس سهل. This is an easy lesson. هذا أسهل درس في الكتاب. هذا أسهل درس في الكتاب. This is the easiest lesson in the book. الدكتور زكريا طبيب شهير. الدكتور زكريا طبيب شهير. Dr. زكريا is a famous doctor. Dr. زكريا is a famous doctor. الدكتور زكريا أشهر طبيب في بلدنا. الدكتور زكريا أشهر. This is a mistake. It's not shadda. A mistake. It's supposed to rub it off. الدكتور زكريا أشهر طبيب في بلدنا. Dr. Zakaria is the most famous doctor in our country. الأزهر جامعة قديمة. الأزهر جامعة قديمة. أزهر is an old university. الأزهر أقدم جامعة في العالم. الأزهر أقدم جامعة في العالم. Azhar is the oldest university in the world. عالم in the world. Next one. الأستاذ نعمان مدرس حسن. الأستاذ نعمان مدرس حسن. أستاذ نعمان is a good teacher. الأستاذ نعمان أحسن مدرس في المدرسة. الأستاذ نعمان أحسن مدرس في المدرسة. أستاذ نعمان is the best teacher in the school. ذلك درس صعب. ذلك درس صعب. That is a difficult lesson. ذلك أصعب درس في الكتاب. ذلك أصعب درس في الكتاب. That is the most difficult lesson in the book. هذا فصل واسع. هذا فصل واسع. This is a spacious classroom. هذا أوسع فصل في الكلية. هذا أوسع فصل في الكلية. This is the most spacious classroom in the faculty. So that's where we stopped in terms of homework. We have some more exercises left. We're going to set this as homework and explain it next lesson, inshallah. Exercise number 6 says, اقرأ المثالين. Read the two examples. ثم اربط بين كل جملتين فيما يلي مستعملا لكن. Then connect between the two sentences in that which follows using لكن. واعلم أن لكن من أخوات إن. Bearing in mind that لكن is from the sisters of إن. So, as we mentioned, Inna and its sisters, there are 6 ahruf in total. And they all have the same grammatical function. They make the ism mansub and the khabar marfu'. They make the ism mansub and the khabar marfu'. And they all enter upon the jumla ismiya. They only enter upon the jumla ismiya. So from the sisters of Inna is lakinna. And lakinna is harfu istidrak. Harfu istidrakin. Harfu, this is the meaning of, like, inna and anna was tawkid, right? Harfu istidrakin is lakinna. Harfu, harfus, this is Hamzatul Wasl, istidrakin. Harfu istidrak, what is harfu istidrak? Harfu istidrak is basically where you mention a statement, and then that statement may be misunderstood. And because that statement is may be misunderstood, you bring lakinna after it and then clarify or remove that misunderstanding by mentioning something which seems contrary to what you mentioned previous to it. The same meaning as however. So you mention something. For example, Muhammadun qawiyun. Muhammad is strong. From this, it may be understood that he is brave. Strength and bravery is something which is commonly related. So because of this misunderstanding, we now come and use lakinna to remove this misunderstanding. So we'd say, Muhammadun qawiyun, lakinnahu jabanun. Lakinnahu jabanun. Muhammad is strong. But don't misunderstand, however, he is a coward. He is a coward. Likewise, many a times we connect and relate a person being haughty and proud with richness. So we say Muhammadun ghaniyun. Muhammad is rich. From that, many people understand that he is someone who is arrogant, someone who is conceited. So we come and say lakinnahu. But bear in mind, he is not as you may have thought. Lakinnahu mutawadi'un. Muhammadun ghaniyun, lakinnahu mutawadi'un. Muhammad is rich, however, he is humble. He is humble. So that's what you're going to notice in these sentences. You're going to see a statement is made, and then you find after lakinna another statement which seems contradictory to what came before it. And that's why it's mentioned. Lakinna is harf sidrak, because what comes after it has come to clarify what may have been misunderstood from the statement before it. So here we have at-tullabu kathirun. The students are many. When we say the students are many, what's understood from that is that the classroom that they're in is spacious. It fits all of them. But al-faslu saghirun, the classroom is small. So we need to bring lakinna in between. When we bring lakinna, Now that we know what it means, we also have to apply the grammatical function. So al-faslu is going to become al-fasla, lakin al-fasla. So ismu lakinna, saghirun remains saghirun, khabaru lakinna. The same thing that we covered in lesson 1. The same thing. So if you don't remember this, you need to go back to lesson 1 and revise. So here's the example that they've mentioned. They've two different sentences, lakinna, in between. Al-tullabu kathirun, the students are many. Lakinna al-fasla saghirun, however the classroom is small. Hamidun mujtahidun, Hamid is hardworking. Sadiquhu kaslan, his friend is lazy. You'd think that a hardworking person, he befriends those who are hardworking like him. However, Hamid, he's chosen the wrong friend. Hamidun mujtahidun, Hamid is hardworking. Lakinna sadiqahu, sadiqahu. So sadiq is the mubtada of this sentence previously. Now it becomes ismu lakinna mansub. Wa mudaf mudaf ilayh kaslanu. I don't know why it has dhammatain here. I shouldn't have dhammatain. It should be one dhamma because mamnu' min as-sarf. This one is right. لكن صديقه كسلان. However, his friend is lazy. So this is what we have to do. We have two sentences. One is يعني, a statement that's made. And then because it might be misunderstood, we bring لكن and then mention the or remove the misunderstanding by mentioning another statement, and then we have to apply the grammatical function of lakin. The next exercise: اقرأ المثالين ثم أدخل كأن على الجمل الآتية علما بأن كأن من أخوات إن. We need to read the two examples once again here, and then insert كأن into the following sentences, bearing in mind that كأن is from the sisters of إن. So from the sisters of إن also is كأن. كأن is from the sisters of إن, and the meaning of كأن, it comes for harfu tashbihin. Harfu tashbih. Tashbih means resembling, resemblance. It comes to show resemblance of something. Ka'anna is actually, if you go back to its origin, it's kaf and anna. Kaf and anna. Anna is from the sisters of inna, right? Emphasis. Kaf is an harf, is a harf jar on its own. Kaf is harfu jarrin, which comes for tashbih. So I would say Muhammadun, for example. Muhammadun is like a lion. Ka, I'll bring ka, and I'll say asadin. Muhammad ka asadin. That's a sentence. Muhammad ka asad. Muhammad is like a lion. Is like a lion. It's a harf jar. But when Anna joined, it changed. It became from the sisters of Inna. So this is a more emphasized tashbih than this one, because this one does not have Anna. So this is tawkid, emphasizing the tashbih. طيب. And it does the same grammatical function as Inna. It's not a harf jar no more. But just to explain the origin, is that kaf comes for tashbih. Muhammadun ka asadin is like a lion. So ka'anna, harfu tashbih, comes to show resemblance, and it's more emphasized than just the kaf. With the anna, it's more emphasized. So we need to read the two examples. Man hadha al-fata, who is this young man? Ka'annahu akhuka, it is as though he is your brother. Ka'anna, harfu tashbih. The ha is ismu ka'anna, and akhu is khabaru ka'anna, wa huwa mudaf mudaf ilayhi. The second example: من هذه الطفلة؟ من هذه الطفلة؟ Who is this young girl? كأنها أختك. It's as though she is your sister. كأنها أختك. كأن حرف تشبيه. ها, that ضمير is اسم كأن, and أخت is خبر كأن وهو مضاف مضاف إليه. So that's what you need to do. You need to insert كأن into these sentences. طيب. And when you insert the كأن, remember, اسم كأن, if it's a ضمير منفصل, it changes into the متصل version, just like إن and هو, it becomes إنه. طيب. اقرأ ما يلي, read the following. This is basically the rules that we mentioned from 11 to 19. The rules for 11 to 19, we said that 11 to 19, they are أعداد مركبة, they are compound numbers made up of two parts, the units and the tens. both parts are mabni on fatha. Both parts are mabni on fatha in all of the cases except for two. In ithna ashara, the two in ithna ashara is not mabni on fatha. Rather, it changes. It becomes ithna if it's marfu' and ithnay if it's majur or mansub. So this is the only one that changes. Everything else remains with the fatha at the end. We also said the thing that is counted from 11 all the way to 99, it is tamiz, which means that it comes as a mufrad, mudhakkar, mansub noun. The thing that's been counted, the ma'dud. And then we mentioned 11 and 12, both parts, the units and the tens, they correspond to the thing that's been counted in gender. So this is mudhakkar because this is mudhakkar. This is mudhakkar because this is mudhakkar. So both parts match. But from 13 to 19, the tens is going to match. The 10 matches with the thing that's been counted in gender. So mudhakkar, so the ashara is mudhakkar without the tamarbuta. However, the units from 3 to 9, they are going to oppose. So this is mu'annath, this is mudhakkar. Mu'annath, mudhakkar. This was explained last lesson in more detail. But this is what we need to do here. So the author here, he's counting something which is mudhakkar. But when we explain the rules for both mudhakkar and mu'annath. So we're one step ahead. The additional number here is ishroon. Ishroon means 20. Ishroon is 20. And the rules that we mentioned do not encompass ishroon. It stops at 19. The only thing that is encompassed is the tamiz, the ma'dud. It continues all the way to 99. So taliban, we've spoken about that. So ahada ashara taliban, up to ishroona taliban is what we need to read as homework for number 8. Number 9, اقرأ ما يلي ثم اكتبه مع كتابة الأرقام الواردة فيه بالحروف. اقرأ ما يلي, read that which follows. ثم اكتبه مع كتابة الأرقام, then write it out. Writing out the numbers الواردة فيه بالحروف. Spelling out the numbers in words, basically. Writing out the numbers in words. That's number 9. Exercise number 10 is اقرأ ما يلي. We need to read the following. And this is what we spoke about with regards to the Al-A'daad Al-Tartibiyya, the ordinal numbers. Al-Darsu Al-Awwal, the first lesson. Al-Darsu Al-Thani, the second lesson. You need to read this up to Al-Darsu Al-Ashir. And remember, they come on the wazn of fa'il, except for Al-Awwal. Al-Awwal is an exception. Al-Awwal Mu'annathuhu Al-Ula. Al-Awwal, its mu'annath form is Al-Ula. We say نقولوا الطالب الأول, the first student, والطالبة الأولى, and the first students. This is male, masculine, this is feminine. الأول, الأولى. And we said that these ordinal numbers, they usually come as نعت. In the sentences, they usually come as نعت. Exercise number 11. إنعت الأسماء الآتية. إنعت الأسماء الآتية بالعدد الترتيبي المشتق. بالعدد الترتيبي المشتق من العدد المذكور أمام كل واحد منها. We need to إنعت الأسماء الآتية. We need to give a نعت. Describe the following nouns using the ordinal numbers, عدد الترتيبي, using the ordinal numbers extracted, المشتق, which is derived, من العدد المذكور, from the number that is mentioned, أمام كل واحد منها, in front of all of the sentences. So basically, the number that is mentioned in the brackets, we need to, from this number, derive an ordinal number. So if it's 8, thamaniya, we need to transfer it into thamin, thamin, and then use it as na'at. So if the thing that we're describing does not have alif lam, we're going to say thamin. But if it has alif lam, we're going to say athamin. So here we'd say al-yawm athamin, al-yawmu thaminu. Both have to be with the dhamma because the of the rules for na'at man'ut. If it was mu'annath, if it was as-sayyara, we'd say as-sayyaratu thaminatu, adding the ta marbuta, so it matches in gender. So the same rules for na'at man'ut have to be applied here because we're describing using this ordinal number. So this is exercise number 11. Exercise number 12 says, يوجه المدرس للطلاب أسئلة مكونة من أليس كذلك. The teacher is going to direct questions to the students And this question is made up of أليس كذلك? Is that not the case? فيجيب عليها الطلاب ببلا. And then the students are going to answer to this question with بلا. نحو, for example, أنت من الهند, you are from India. أليس كذلك? Is that not the case? And the student answers بلا. Of course, that's the case. أنت مريض, you are sick. أليس كذلك? Is that not the case? The student answer as بلا. أنت مسلم, أليس كذلك? You are Muslim. Is that not the case? بلا. أنت رجل, you are a man. أليس كذلك? Say بلا. In the case of men, in the case of the sisters, أنت امرأة, you are a woman. أليس كذلك? Is that not the case? بلا. And so on. Number 13, and this is the final one. أيهما, which of the two? يشير المدرس إلى طالبين. The teacher is going to point to two students, ويقول, and he's going to say, هذان طالبان. These are two students. أيهما أطول, which of the two is taller? وإلى كتابين, and he's going to point to two books, and he's going to say, ويقول, هذان كتابان. أيهما أجمل. These are two books. أيهما أجمل, which of the two is more beautiful? وهكذا, and so on. So maybe you can construct five sentences like this, where a person, he points to two things, there's two cars in front of him. How would you point to two cars? You'd say, هاتاني سيارتاني أيهما أجمل. هاتاني سيارتاني, these two are cars. Which of the two is more beautiful? So practice using أيهما. These two I don't think we're going to cover, because these, it needs a physical interaction, and we don't have that. So we'll cover all of the previous exercises except these two, inshallah. But for your sake, your own practice sake, construct five questions for each. الكلمات الجديدة, new words. مهجع, dormitory. مهاجع is the plural. مهاجع ممنوع من الصرف. مهاجع is ممنوع من الصرف. كوكب, star. كواكب is the plural. واسع, spacious. فريق is a team. فرقاء is the plural. شقيق is blood relative. أشقاء is the plural. ثمن is the price. عالم the world. شهير famous. شهر month. Two plurals. شهور أشهر. لاعب is a player. لاعب كرة football player. لاعب كرة سلة basketball player, and so on. لاعب. The plural of لاعب, لاعبون. في المنام, in the dream. Manam is dream. Al-Azhar is the Azhar University in Egypt. Azhar University, they have a lot of people of innovation teaching there, and they have Ash'arism and so on. So it's not a place that a person is recommended to go and study. Barakallahu feekum. Subhanakallahu bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.